Hey guys, welcome back to Flatpak Effects, and in today's tutorial, we're going to be making this. So stick around, you're watching Flatpak Effects. Alright, so let's get started. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to make this iPhone text message effect. Before we get started, you're going to need to download a file off my Google Drive. Now I've put the link in the description below, and all you need to do is just download that text bubble image, and then we can get started. Alright, so once you've downloaded that, you can right click, import file, and just navigate to wherever you saved it, and then just hit open. Next, you're going to want to right click, new composition, and we're going to call this one text message. Set this one to be 1080x25 and set the duration to be about 10 seconds and then hit OK. All right, next we're going to grab our text bubble layer and just drag it straight into that composition. Now you'll see by the image, I've already laid out the text bubbles of where they roughly need to be. So next we're going to come down to the layer and I'm going to navigate down to the opacity and I'm just going to drop this down to 85. Now that'll come into effect later when you drop this layer over your footage. It'll make the bubbles slightly transparent just to help sell the effect. All right, so next we need to separate the bubbles that we actually want to use. So for my first layer, I'm going to take this top bubble. So I'm going to hit G on the keyboard or switch to my pen tool. And I'm just going to roughly mask out this top bubble. Next, we're going to want to actually animate that bubble. So we want it to actually pop in like we've seen in the example. So the way we do this is first we need to move the anchor point. So I'm going to hit Y on the keyboard and I'm going to drag this anchor point so it lines up roughly in the corner of the text bubble. Then I'm going to go down to my transform menu and I'm going to create a keyframe for the scale. I'm going to move along slightly and I'm going to create another keyframe. I'm going to go along slightly again, create another one. Then a little bit further on, I'm going to create another one there as well. Now I'm just going to come back to this middle one here. And I'm going to scale this up to about 105. And I'm going to come back to my first keyframe. And I'm going to make this 0. Next, I'm going to right click on this middle one here. I'm going to go down to keyframe assist. And I'm going to create an easy ease. That's just going to help soften that out. Now, if I just play through that, you can see we've already got the basic animation of the text bubble. So that looks pretty good. It's got that little bounce on the end. All right, so I'm happy with that. Next, I'm going to right click and I'm going to create new text. And I'm going to type out j.peterson/forward/3:05 p.m. Now, this is what's going to appear above each of the text bubbles. So this you can change to whatever initial and surname you want. And the time, again, you can change this to whatever you want as well. Now, once you've actually typed that out, you're going to want to come over to your character menu. If your character menu is not there, go up to Window and then down to Character. And you're going to want to make this Helvetica New. And you're going to want to make this thin. And I'm just going to scale this down. And I'm just going to position this just above the text bubble, slightly justified in from the right. Next, I'm going to right click new text, and this is going to be your actual text message. So I've just written, hey, finished early, let's meet up. And for the text message, I'm going to make this light. So it makes it slightly bolder than the thin. And I'm just going to position this in the speech bubble. I'm also just going to scale this up slightly just to fill. And I'm just going to reposition this here. Next, with my text layer selected, I'm going to come up to Effects and Presets. And I'm simply just going to write Type. And this is what we want here under Animate In. We want this typewriter. And I'm just going to drag this on. Now, if we select that layer and hit U on the keyboard, you can see it's created these two keyframes. So that's when the animation starts and when the animation ends. I'm just going to drag this endpoint in just to speed it up. And you can see that's how fast you want it to be. So if you want it slower, if you want it fast, just drag it closer or further away. Next, we're just going to time that text as it comes in. So as the speech bubble comes up, we're then just going to drag this start point just in. So you can see we've got it sort of timed right as it pops up. And we're also going to grab our top layer and we're going to create a fade in for that one. So I'm just going to use my drop down to go to transform, create a keyframe for my opacity. I'm going to go along on the timeline, and I'm simply just going to drag those ones underneath and just move them slightly along on the timeline. So this is what we should end up with now. So that's pretty much it. That's the basic effect. So to do the other ones, all you need to do is basically just duplicate what you've got. So I'm going to take all of these layers. I'm going to come up to edit and then down to duplicate. And I'm simply just going to drag those ones underneath and just move them slightly along on the timeline. Now, obviously the speech bubble's the wrong way. So what we're actually going to do is select that bubble layer, go down to masks, and we're just going to delete the mask. Now all I need to do is just go to my pen tool or G on the keyboard. And all I need to do is just simply draw a mask around that bubble as well. Next, we need to move the anchor point for that layer. So with my layer selected, I'm going to hit Y on the keyboard and we're going to drag that anchor point down to this corner now. So that's going to animate in from that side now. And the last thing is just to grab those two text layers and just move them down and reposition them. So I'm just going to change this text. So now that one should animate in as well. So again, here you can change the actual surname because obviously it's someone else responding. And that's pretty much it. You can pretty much just repeat this process until you've typed out your whole conversation. Now, a few things to know is I've given you a few different sizes of text bubbles here, but you can actually take these and resize them to what you need. I can actually rescale this to make it bigger or smaller. The other thing you can do is you can come up to Effect, you can go down to Generate, and you can come down to Fill, and you can make this whatever color you want. So on the iPhone, they have a green version as well, so you can make this green. It's that easy. So you can easily change the colors of these and do whatever you want. Now, once you've actually finished your comp like this and you've got your text message laid out, the last step is all you need to do is create a new composition, drag your footage in, position that how you want. And here I've just added a lens flare for effect. And then all you need to do is just drag your text message layer over the top. Now, one last thing I've also done is I've actually done a motion track so that it sticks inside the frame. So you can see it's actually stuck to the pole as the camera actually moves up and down. Now, this just adds a little bit of realism. And the way I've done this is quite simply just done a motion track of that pole. And then I've just parented this layer to that pole. Otherwise, you can just overlay it over the top. It's up to you. So there you go, guys. There's a really easy way to make this text message effect. Take care. Thanks for watching, guys. And remember, Flatpak Effects is the Flatpak anyone can build.